Welcome to a Sunday vlog. Hey, I just made that up now. It's like I said, a 20-year-old girl with big breasts would say. I did a show on GFO reactors and how they work and what you use them for. Well, that's gone. I took it out of the sump, right? I had a mini, then I had a large one, that's what she said, and it's gone, it's out of the sump, all right? And then I had, what else did I have in there? Oh yeah, I had the sump sock in there. Well, that's gone too, it's gone. So now I just have the sump and a protein skimmer and a foam block for my filtration. I did go back to the socks. I got tired, sick and tired of cleaning those damn things. So I'm gonna be thinking about a contraption to build that's easier to clean because they're so filthy and nasty. And I have no problem with touching these things, but you get the rubber gloves, you turn these bastards inside out, you throw them in the washing machine, you do four rinse cycles on cold water, and then you let them air dry for 2 or 3 days and you put them back in. And I've got like 10 of these things, so I really only have to do it once a month, but it's still nasty 30 minutes that I have to spend with these ugly ass socks. I'm gonna find a better way, and we're gonna go from there. Patrick's Dive and Reef has an awesome idea for sump sock replacement. Patrick, if you're watching, I'm sure you are, thank you, sir. Awesome job. He's got this container with some filter floss in it, if that's what you call it. Anyway, check out his video. I'll send a link to it. Patrick, send me the link and I'll put it in the notes below. If it's not there, it means he hasn't done it yet. So that's all I wanted to say. Because what I was doing is vacuuming my sump every week when I do a 10-gallon water change in my 125-gallon aquarium. Because all that stuff, fish waste and uneaten food, just sits at the bottom of the sump and it looks like a yellow-orange mess. Not a big deal. I don't care if it looks messy. I'm just saying, it just seems to be easier to put a sock in. The water looks cleaner because there's not stuff floating around. Whatever. I'm trying to think of the best way to filter with the least amount of maintenance. There's extra electricity, you got the pump, you're cluttering up your sump. I hate that rhymes, you guys know that. Then you got a nitrate reactor, maybe a calcium reactor, maybe, who knows what else you've got. I don't need all this stuff, I don't have time for all this stuff, I don't have the money for all this stuff. So if you see me show things in the future, it's that I'm thinking, well, maybe I will use a GFO reactor, let me buy one. Guess what? Didn't really need it. My tank was fine. Comment and help each other out. Thanks, you guys. Thank you so much. Later.